on Thompson Pass are otherworldly. I've had the luxury of skiing a lot of that area from a heli, but never have I approached Alaska by foot.
This is Tatum.
Nadine Overwater, one of the most badass female snowmobilers on the planet. We got such a badass crew of women here. We got Robin Van Gyn, incredible backcountry snowboarder.
Got Taylor Godber, who's like an amazing big mountain snowboarder, who I'm really excited to go snowboarding with.
Crew is stacked and ready to get after it. Remote and secluded up there that we're really depending on ourselves, and there's no one other than our crew that's gonna be there as a point of safety. So we're making sure we have it all. We started lists weeks ago in advance, and once we're there, we're not getting anything else.
It's not just a like cruise up and get going type trip. Alaska is just a bit larger, a bit more consequential.
And it's a completely different game when you're on a snowmobile. One wrong move or not pulling one side hill and you're in a hole in the middle of a glacier.
So the majority of this trip, we're actually traveling on glaciers. And when we're hiking up lines, there's a lot of birch runs too. So we need to be dialed in on our rope skills.
Wait, face me again.
I gotta get a photo. Hold on.
I got my first power shot. Did you guys rock, paper, scissors?
Robin volunteered herself.
You just handed me the rope.
You were already flipping it.
The anchor on figure eight. Are we good?
You're good.
Camp Cowabunga took a hit the last couple days. We were weathered out for 2 days. It was blowing and snowing. Last night it opened up a little bit, so we went for a little sled ride just out on the flats. So here we are, gassing up.
Thank goodness we've got Nadine here. She's such a sled boss. We're gonna need some serious sled boss maneuvers to get up some of these hills. I think it's gonna be crazy deep. Nadine is a pro.
Glacier sledding is next level, and out here it is eye candy. Beautiful features everywhere, but you really have to like think twice about going straight for it.
Climbing and approaching these faces was just so wild for me. It was very humbling. It was always 10 times more difficult than you thought it would be.
Every corner we turn around is like amazing lines. These drills are pointing out. Our heads are on a swivel. It's just unbelievable out here.
I think it's one thing to be able to pick your line, and then it's a matter of actually getting on top of it.
Wow.
Doing is risky, but like being in the mountains is just inherent. It's just like what comes with it.
Avalanche, you're right, Nadine, if you can. She's good.
Like the boss, Nadine, nice work.
I think Nadine's avalanche scenario was a perfect example of why we plan and why we're working together as a crew to be educated and we have the right safety gear in place for when something like that does happen.
Just to have that level of trust with your friends is something that grows and builds over time, and we're just getting into it, but I feel like we could not have assembled a better crew.
We had some real moments together, and I think that's when your strongest connections are made.